Christmas fills our hearts with joy as we think of gifts, lights, and holiday spirit. But remember, Christmas means something more. It is the birth of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us travel back to Bethlehem and share the story of his birth.
Oh, come, O ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, born the King of angels. Oh, come.
To pass in those days that there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, everyone in his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee into the city of David, and Joseph also went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth into Judea, out unto the city of David, to be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being great with child.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem, how still we see thee lie. Above thy deep and dreamless sleep, the silent stars go by. Yet in thy dark street shineth the everlasting light.
Proclaim thy holy birth. have any room for us in your inn?
No, I'm sorry. Try across the way.
Please, do you have any room for us in your inn?
We have too many guests already. We have no room.
Do you have any room for us in your inn? We have come a long way, and my wife is a child.
All of our rooms are full. I have an empty stable out back you may use. It's not much, but it will give you some shelter.
Joseph, the baby will be coming soon. Let's please go to the stable.
Oh, holy night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. Grateful for the spring.
And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
And there were the same country shepherds abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them, and they were sore afraid.
Fear not, for beyond I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. You shall find the baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward mankind.
Join the triumph of the sky. Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known unto us.
And they came with haste and found Mary, Joseph, and the baby lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known the abroad saying which was concerning this child. And all they that heard it wondered at those things which were told to them by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things pondered in her heart. And the shepherds rejoiced, and the shepherds returned, praising and glorifying God for all the things that they had heard and seen, for it was told unto them. Behold, they came wise men from the east to Jerusalem.
We see that is born the King of Jews, for we have seen his star from the east, and we have come to worship him.
When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we travel so far. Field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star.
And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
See, and heaven and nature see, and heaven and heaven and nature.
we see the twinkling Christmas lights, let us remember the star that led the wise men to seek the Savior. When we give and receive gifts, stop to ponder what gifts we can give to the Christ child. 4. The spirit of Christmas is a spirit of love and of generosity and of goodness. It illuminates the picture windows to the soul. And when we look out upon the world's busy life, we become more interested in people than in things. The spirit of Christmas is something I hope that all of us will have within our hearts and within our lives, not only at this particular season, but also throughout the years. A wise Christian once urged, "Let us not spend Christmas, but let us keep Christmas in our hearts and in our lives."